So I want to talk about this equation with you guys. How do we solve an equation with a rational exponent? Here we have x to the 2 over 3 equals 64. Well, if we raise both sides to the reciprocal power, which is 3 over 2, when we multiply the powers, 2 and 2 cancel, 3 and 3 cancel, so we just get x to the first power, and that's equal to, and we just have to work this out, right? And to do so, you can look at 64 as 2 times 2, no, many times, 2 to the 6th power. And then raise to that power. And here we can multiply the powers, so we can get x equals 2 to the 6 times 3 over 2. And 6 times 3 over 2 is just equal to 9, so x is equal to 2 to the 9th power. And you can work that out, it's 512. But let me tell you, this is incorrect. I should say, this is incomplete. Can we see the mistake with this? Okay, the reason that this is wrong is because right here, we need plus or minus. So we're just missing the negative solution. So why is that though? It seems pretty good, right? Well, let me change this into the radical form and it will become much more clear. When we have x to the 2 over 3 power equals 64. If you first change the 3 from the exponent right here into a radical, then you get the radical of x to the second power equals 64. And now you see we have an x squared equation. Yes, but first we should get rid of the 3 right here, right? And this is in the radical, so just raise both sides to the third power so that this and that can cancel. And then right here, x squared equals 64 to the third power. I'm not going to work this out yet, okay? Now, when we have x squared equals a positive number, yes, we can take the square root both sides, and this and that will cancel, but you just have to remember you put a plus or minus. Whenever you solve an equation, when you take the square root both sides, don't forget the negative version will also work. And then right here, we'll get x is equal to plus or minus. To work this out, in fact, you can actually do the square root of 64 first, and then the third power after that. And this right here, it's equal to 8. So you just have to do 8 to the third power. So x is equal to. So you can just do 8 times 8 times 8, and that will give you 512. Or if you look at this as 2 to the third power, right? Because 8 is the same as 2 to the third power. And then raised to the third power is the same as 2 to the ninth power. But anyways though, plus or minus, the answer for this is 512. So this right here is the correct answer.